Hey, what's up? It's your girl Raquel Angela, and I'm back with another Motivational Monday video. How have you guys been doing? How was your Thanksgiving? I hope it went well. Mine was good. I ate and ate and ate until I could not eat anymore, okay? And if you guys are new to my channel, welcome in. I'm Raquel Angela, and this is Motivational Mondays. If you guys are liking my content, feel free to hit the subscribe button. And if you guys are my returning viewers and subscribers, what is up with y'all? How have y'all been? I hope y'all been having a great holiday, and y'all like my little Christmas tree. If you like my Christmas tree, check out my holiday vlogmas video where I have my mom, my brother, my husband, and I was just like recording us doing some Thanksgiving shopping. I shared with some of the food we cooked, even how we put up the Christmas tree. So if you guys have not watched that holiday vlogmas video, check it out. Let me know what you think. And if you guys are liking that type of content, give it a thumbs up so that way I can make some more vlog videos or vlogmas videos for you guys. Now let's get right into this Motivational Monday video, because I want to make this Motivational Monday video like a story time, because I wanted to share with you guys what I've learned in this process of last month. And I just wanted to share with you guys because it motivated myself, and I just wanted, you know, to be able to motivate you, because it is Motivational Mondays and this is what I am all about. So let's get into this Motivational Monday video. So since it's like a story time, basically, let me just like give y'all a heads up of what I've been working on. Now, I'm going to be honest, I'm not going to specifically say exactly what I've been working on because of the things that I had to sign. I can't really say too much of anything quite yet. But the general basis of everything, what made me want to talk about what I've been working on, or even talking about the subject of stop doubting yourself, was the process that I have gone through. So let's go back about a month ago. I posted a video, a Motivational Monday video, which was Motivational Monday number 19, and it was manifestations about a dream job. And I share with you guys 5 positive affirmations about, manifesting your dream job. Like, I have the skills and the abilities for this job. Just certain things like that. And so I was, you know, using that Motivational Monday positive affirmations with me. And I'm so open. I'm at the point in my life where I'm open to new possibilities and new things that's coming to me, and that's what this whole Motivational Monday thing is about. I'm not just sharing this type of information just because. I'm sharing it because not only am I using it for myself, but I'm realizing that it has been very beneficial for me in my life. The things that I've been saying, and it's been helping me to stay positive. It's been helping me to be in control of my thoughts. So whenever I'm, you know, feeling down, or whenever I'm thinking negatively, I've been getting to the point where I'm like, I'm conscious enough, so I'm like, wait a minute, Raquel, you're tripping, fix it. You know, stop saying you can't and say that you can, or stop saying it won't happen where you're saying that it will happen or it is coming to me. And like, I've been paying attention to a lot of my thoughts that have been going in my head. So going back to that Motivational Monday video number 19, where I was sharing those manifestation affirmations for a dream job, or just a job in general, that you basically, it was just to get us in the headspace to where we are ready and are open to receive all these new possibilities, jobs, or that we have the skills for this job. So long story short, I basically was in this play that I've been working on for the last few months now, and it debuted on October 27th, which was like a Sunday. And it was in a very emotional process for me, but also in the midst of it, I learned a lot about myself. In the midst of me going back into theater, because that was my first time in years being back on stage, because since I had moved to Atlanta, since I had graduated, I've been focusing more so on film and TV, working in front of the camera, trying to understand, you know, how film works, because I've gone to school for theater, so I know how the theater runs. So I took on this opportunity, and in that process, I found strength in myself that I didn't even know that I had. I was able to speak up in certain moments when I normally would be quiet and I just kind of sit back, but I was speaking up and I'm like, wait a minute, I went to college for theater, and there's some things and some knowledge that I still have that's embedded in me, and not only just on the acting part, but behind the scenes, directing, producing, that type of part of theater. And so I was able to find the strengths that I had within myself, and I was really proud of myself. So once I did the play and it ended and I saw my mom and I saw, you know, my friend and my husband, I really got a little emotional for a second, because it was like the process that I have gone through. Like, my mom kept saying, you know, Raquel, you did it, you did it. And I was just, I had to think, like, I did it. It's been so long. And so at the moment in my life, because it's been so long for me doing theater, I'm not gonna lie to you, I doubted myself a little bit. I doubted, like, can I even really do this? Am I still good at it? You know, I'm very hard on myself when it comes to my craft. I think because I love it so much, and I've been trying to work on this since I was a kid. So me being in the field, I'm always hard on myself. But in that process, I had to realize I had to stop doubting myself, and that everything that I have gone through and everything that I have learned in college has brought me to the point where I'm at right now in life. And so that process had really got me thinking. And that evening, my mom and I and my husband, we were waiting at a restaurant. We were just waiting for them to seat us. And I received a phone call. From that phone call, it turned into another job opportunity. Mind you, I didn't go and ask this person for the job. I didn't know what was coming up next. I just didn't know what my next job opportunity was going to be when it came to my acting or being in the entertainment industry. I just didn't know. And they were like, hey, are you available tomorrow, as in Monday? And I was like, yeah, I am available. Now, my mom was still to be here, but I couldn't take her to the airport because I had to, you know, be at that job at 7 something in the morning. But she was just like, do it. And I was like, I'm sorry, mom. I was like, I know you'll be back in like a few weeks for Thanksgiving. We'll spend some more time together. But my mom understood the process of it, of me, you know, that opportunity coming. And once I stepped foot into that role the next day in that position, I was in a place in my life where I never in a million years thought that I would be able to step foot in. And I don't want to go into too much detail because, again, I can't say too much of everything of what I've been doing because I do sign paperwork. But I just wanted to give y'all the overall basis of the reason why I'm sharing this story time. But in the midst of me in that environment, walking up and down stairs, elevators, in the building, and just walking around that environment, for a second, I was just like in disbelief, like, oh my gosh, like, is this real? You know, and no, it wasn't an acting job, but I can say it was still in the field, which is a blessing, because in theater, not only did I just learn the acting part about it, but I learned sound, I've learned props, I've learned how to build a set stage if I needed to do that on my own. I've worked in costumes. So just being able to just step foot, still in the environment that I want to be in, but just in another little area, was very huge to me. And then I started thinking, as, you know, days went by, my first week went by, and I was just like, wait a minute. Was I not, a couple weeks ago, just saying these positive affirmations about a dream job or about me having the skills to work this job? Because I'm not gonna lie to you, even though I was just still disbelief and just like, oh my gosh, I cannot believe my eyes where I'm at right now or where I'm working, I started doubting myself a little bit because it's like, am I even supposed to be here? But then I had to think, wait a minute. Everything that I have gone through in my life has brought me right to the moment where I was. It brought me to the moment to receive that phone call, to be able to accept the work, to work at that place that I was at. And never in a million years would I have thought it gone that way. There's a lot of things that I want to accomplish in my life. And I'm realizing and I'm understanding, as we're going through this journey called life, there are going to be times where we think we want it done a certain way, but that's not how it's going to happen. Sometimes it's going to be done differently. And in my situation, it was just done, you know, a little bit different. And I'm not complaining about it because that's something that I get to put on my resume. And the crazy thought about it was that I was about to start doubting myself. And I had to stop myself because I said, wait a minute, Raquel. weren't you just feeling or thinking the same way when you were in that play, but you did it and it went well? And then now, look where you are now. Everything that you have gone through, I had to tell myself this, everything that you have gone through, all the way from high school when you were in Hairspray as Motormouth Maybelle, when you were in college and you played these several different roles in college, and you were doing all these different things. You moved to Atlanta and you started doing background acting, and you're doing all this different type of stuff, and then now it's placed you to right where you are. And it was right where I needed to be. So I'm sharing this because I want you guys to stay strong in this process. There are gonna be times, like I always say, there are gonna be times where there's gonna be things and moments that's gonna try to hit you and try to knock you down and try to deter you to move a different way. You have to keep pressing on. You have to keep moving forward. You have to take in these certain things. But I want you guys to stay motivated and keep your eye on the prize. And always, always be open to receiving good things into your life. Always know that something good is coming around the corner. So when one job ends, I know something else is coming around the corner because I am open to receiving it. But you have to be in that headspace. It's easier said than done. But once you start getting into that practice of saying these I am affirmations or saying these positive affirmations, declaring these positive things over your life, and you actually start to believe it, like really believe it, that anything that you put your mind to, that it is possible. You have to believe it. Because I promise you, all the legwork that I have done this year, if I didn't do it, I would not have gotten that job opportunity. And I'm just saying, if I did not move to Atlanta 2.5 years ago, I would have not gotten that job opportunity. But it took me and my husband to take a leap of faith to do what we have to do to get us here to a state we've never lived before. A state maybe we visited here and there, barely seen enough. But we took that leap of faith and we did it. Sometimes you have to plan, and sometimes you have to prepare for the things that you're asking for. So the things that I've been asking for, whether they're coming to me verbatim exactly what I've said, or if not, they're coming to me in ways that I never even thought. But I had to go through certain things in my life to get me to where I'm at today. So I had to stop doubting myself. I had to completely stop it. There were moments where people tried to break me down in the midst of it, but I kept holding on because I'm like, no, I'm right where I'm supposed to be for a reason. And it's no cockiness with that. It's just telling yourself and knowing deep down inside that you were given this life in this moment for a reason. So take it with you, because whatever that I have done and that I have learned, I'm taking it with me because it was a lesson, because it's going to prepare me for the next thing that I'm going to have. Whether it's a job, a moment, a person I meet, whatever it is, a place that I have to go, whatever it is, it's gonna be there for me right when it's supposed to happen. So I want you guys to stop doubting yourself. Believe in your skills, believe in your abilities, and believe in yourself, and know that everything that you have is instilled in you to get you to where you're trying to go, and it's there for you for the job that you want, the career that you want, the anything that you want in life. It's right there inside you, but you have to take out the time to fix your wrongs and to keep going. We're not perfect. I'm not perfect. I'm still learning. I'm still a work in progress. But I can say that I've come a long way. And whatever it is that I've done this year is going to catapult me into next year. And I hope it is the same for you. And I hope you guys take this story time, or this little testimony time, this Motivational Monday, for you guys to take it in and really be able to look into your life, because we're creeping down to the last few weeks of 2019. But don't be scared. 2020 is going to be a great and awesome year. It's going to be a big year for you, but you have to believe that it's going to be an awesome, great year, and that it's going to be huge for you. Believe it. I promise you, once you believe it, you'll be open to receiving. I am your girl, Raquel Angela. I'm here to bring peace, love, with a little bit of light. And don't forget, an A plus vibe leads to an A plus life. And stop doubting yourself. Y'all have a happy and great Monday. Enjoy your week. Let's get into planning an awesome 2020. I hope y'all have a good one. Thank you for watching. Yeah.